guys, Tattoo For You Richard here, and...
me!
My wife.
What's up, peoples?
So, it is time for our Monday Q&A video. Woohoo! Q&A comment video, whatever you want to call it, whatever you feel like doing in the comments below. Asking questions.
Don't get weird down there, though. Like, you can't say whatever you feel like doing in the comments. Like, that's
just...
okay, get weird. You can get weird.
You just said get weird down there. And lately things have been taking a turn for the innuendos.
It just happens. I don't know. It's the time of year, right? I feel very...
it's a time of year. Christmas time is the time of year for naughtiness.
It's the cold. It's the cold time when you snuggle.
Oh, yeah, and you snuggle and get all close.
We made our child laugh with our snuggles. Right. Snuggling's how you got here, kid.
Well.
Okay, are we ready?
Sure.
Ready? Let's just jump right into the questions. We got nothing else really going on. So, we had a fun week.
The week was great. But then we went to a party Friday night and had a blast. And then yesterday we were dead. Both of us. Like,
yeah.
Dead. And this guy was even more dead today. Like, I was thinking, I'm going to have to do Q&A by myself. Like, and then I can't because, like, all these nerd questions.
I had my normal chills happen that Friday night. Like, we were in bed and I got the chills and I wrapped up in the blanket and sweated it out. And I just felt gross yesterday. And today I woke up and just headaches and, like, I was dizzy. Like, it's kind of like... I could open one eye okay, the other eye okay, but if I opened them together, it was like, oh, the house is spinning, so. I feel better now. Just that cloud head.
Yeah. From being sick today.
Yeah. Question time.
Okay. Jim White, congratulations on the game of 40K and the 300 subscribers.
Thank you, sir.
Scraggard. Congrats, dude. A well-deserved 300. Hey, now you're part of a muscular bunch of men holding off a million invaders, but I think the channel is worth a lot more than that. Keep it up, huh? Got you three times in one question, Red. Whatever. Not only did I get you sounding like you was desperate for a wee, LOL, and unable to say the question, but I asked how many S's, S and P in that? The word that. Wow.
Gotcha.
Winning, LOL. Richard, it depends on which mince pie you choose. It could be the beef or soaked fruit Christmas kind. Great vid, guys. Yay. I'm famous enough to have a pet named after me. Yay.
I had only ever heard of the sweet kind of minced meat pie. Like, I never tried it because it scared me.
I'm not going to call him a chicken today. I'm not in the mood.
Whoa.
Scraggly chicken.
The children are yelling at me for not calling you my scraggly chicken. Anyway. Question, Richard. Let's get Christmas going. Have you or have you ever thought of converting a time of year themed model?
I hadn't, honestly, until this question, and I saw somebody else doing it. Big Mac Danskull did one. He did a little Santa Claus guy, barbarian Santa Claus guy. I was like, oh, that's kind of cool.
But he's not creepy.
I just don't know if I, what?
He's not creepy. Some nerd.
That's my daughter.
Some models are scary.
Oh, some creepy. Models are scary.
I don't have any creepy models over here.
This guy looks kind of like a weird crab. Like, he's got little pinchers.
That's not my model.
Oh.
That belongs to somebody else. I just painted it for them.
Oh. Surprise.
You can show it. It's fine.
Oh, wait, right over here.
I painted that for Mr. Darklight Dreamer on YouTube. He left it here when he came out here. No. Oh, gosh. So gross. Get ready for your model to have my wife's boogers on it.
Here you go, Darklight Dreamer. Here's your model.
And she's going to break it, too. I hope you get booby models.
Ooh. He's so special.
Oh my
love
God.
Love you, Raz.
Okay. His name is Raspberry.
Raspberry. Okay. Red, geez, now you know I caught you out. I have to think extra hard to do it again. Let's see. Okay, how about a plain riddle this time? If I drink, I die. If I eat, I'm fine. What am I? I have no clue. That's it. We're done. Wow. You got me.
Daddy!
I actually read this at the beginning of the week, and I was trying to think about it, but then life happens, and you get busy, and I was going to Google the answer, and then I got busy, and honestly, I prefer puns over riddles.
Rose is good at riddles.
I'm more of a pun person.
So, okay, say it again so Rose
okay,
can hear.
Rose wants to know, if I drink, I die. If I eat, I'm fine. What am I? Is it a fish? No. I don't know.
I had the answer to it when I read it the first time, but I can't even think of it for the life of me right now.
Rose is good
if
at
I
riddles.
Drink, I die.
Answer in the comments below.
If I eat, I'm fine.
What am I? Okay, we're going to move on now. Thanks, Scrat Guard.
Didn't we say something in the comments about it?
The other day, Caitlin asked me a riddle and I just said the answer.
The family. He said keep the family involved and be patient while people find you. Just keep up the good work on your channel. Dark Light Dreamer. My little bestie is so freaking adorably precious. Isn't she? She's asleep right now.
Oh, the answer is fire. By the way.
Really?
That's what it was. Yeah, because if you give the fire water, it dies. If you give it, if you feed it wood,
it's.
Yeah.
Fire like my hair.
It's fine. It gets bigger.
I knew the answer to it. I just couldn't. My
I'm more of a pun person, so Scrat Guard, give me some puns next week. I love puns. Puns are funny. Okay. Dark Light Dreamer. My little bestie is so freaking adorably precious. Love the drawings from both girls. I'm going to have to give her a shout out in my upcoming Q&A video. We miss you guys already. I can't wait until we get to visit you all again. My question for the week revolves around tattoos again. In a couple of movies and books, I've seen characters that have tattoos that are imbued with spells and they simply channel a little magic into them to use the spell, which relate to the tattoo itself. For instance, one character had wing tattoos that became wings of light that allowed him to fly. Another had a shield on his arm that would project a magic barrier when activated. If you could have a tattoo like that, which ones would you guys have? I'd have like an invisibility kind. I instantly started thinking about that show, that movie in the show, where they had the runes on them.
Oh, okay.
Remember, what was that?
Immortal Instruments or something like that or whatever it is.
Yeah.
Something or others.
Something like that.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think something that I could like have invisibility turn on and off. So you could be like a fly on the wall in rooms and stuff like that. And yeah. And then fly. I think it'd be nice to be able to fly because you can get places. Although then I'm sure like the government would put some kind of like rules on that and you wouldn't be allowed to fly anywhere. It'd be so boring and lame. So, anyway, invisibility.
No, what's funny is that game that I liked, I talked to you about the other day, Rifts, that's a thing in there. You have their magical tattoos a person can get. And I used to love that concept. And right before one of my characters died, he was about to get a bunch of them, but he ended up getting killed. But flying is definitely one I want. Invisibility sounds cool.
If you can turn it on and off, I wouldn't want to always.
I would want flying, and I would want breathing underwater. Like I would tattoo little gills or a fish behind my ear, and I could touch it, and then that would turn it like give me some gills where I could breathe in the water. I would swim for days.
And like for an invisible tattoo, it'd be like a little person that's like tattooed in white or like tattooed in like black light or glow in the dark color, so you can't really see it
because
it's invisible.
Or tan.
And then I would want a raven. Because I always loved, like I have a D&D character who is familiar. His little buddy is a raven. And yeah, I would want a little pet raven that I could call on a whim. So yeah, that'd be cool. Well, I thought about these things before. We need to get some role playing going.
Wargamer Sean, cool man, good video. Take care. Any holiday traditions that you do? The tree, you know, just decorating the house. We'll do cookies.
We used to have one before I got married, when I still lived at home and stuff, and on Christmas, we'd all go to my grandmother's house. This was me and a little kid, and they even did it before me and my brother were born. But there is Christmas morning, you get up 5 o'clock in the morning. It's ridiculous, but we did. And my brother would always have the bell, and he would run around and ring the bell at 5 o'clock in the morning to wake everybody up. And then we weren't allowed to go downstairs. We would have to stop at, there was a certain stair you couldn't go past, like step. And we'd have to wait there until everything was all ready. And then my you know, everybody was awake and all good to go. And then my grandmother would come and take a picture. It used to be Polaroid pictures, but then it was like later on regular pictures. Actually, I think it's still it was still Polaroids. But she would take a picture every year, every single Christmas from the moment they moved into that house. So there's a photo album that has all those pictures in it. Like progression, and you watch as people grow older, and then babies are born. Like, oh,
sorry,
that was my man, Jubblies.
The dog was chewing on his butt.
I'm having a Christmas moment here, and you kick me in my nuggies.
Sorry, why are they way down there?
I'm old.
No, you're not.
Enough.
But you're only 37. I'm 38. I have no clue.
38. There you go. Oh, anyway, so yeah, there's pictures of all that. You can see all of us grow up and eventually realize that the stairwell is too small. So we don't do that anymore because we don't live out there. So
no, but in our immediate family, we just do like the traditional, you know, visit Santa. Santa comes by on a fire truck next week.
Yay!
Last year we went to a play at a local mega church. And it's like a Broadway play, and it's super amazing. So that's the plan, to do that again this year. I like to make that a tradition for us. Because it's really awesome. It's like a Broadway play, and it's great.
And then we do like
Christmas Eve at his family. And then the next day, we'll do Christmas here in our house. And then whenever we're ready, we go over to my parents' house. So that way, we can still do Christmas with both families.
Yeah.
And it's not all rushed into one day. I like that we separate it like that. I wish we could do that for Thanksgiving, but...
Yeah, Thanksgiving just doesn't work that way.
Thanksgiving is just one day. Yeah. So, I mean, that's a tradition, for sure. It's always been that way. But I can't think of anything, like, that we do in our house that's specific to us that, like, other people don't do.
Yeah. I don't know. We don't have, like, any, like, hardcore traditions yet.
Mm-mm. Your traditions?
Pajamas on Christmas Eve. Yeah. Hey, no, not everybody does that. Caroling, we tried to start. We did that last year, and unfortunately, we had a Christmas party this year, so me and the girls missed caroling. I might start another caroling group since we missed it, but I'm looking at the calendar right now. It's funny because like the first 2 weeks of December are like jam packed with like activities, and then the last 2 weeks is like. So, it's kind of sad if you think about it.
But. Y'all literally have one more week of school, and then y'all are out for Christmas break.
And the kids are out for, like, 2.5 weeks. Okay, anyway, so, yeah, our traditions I don't think are anything different. I thought about bringing Krampus into the house, or Krampus, however you say it.
What?
Because we have some very naughty kids.
I'm looking at it. You literally have a week of school,
okay,
and then you're out.
A half. They get out on, like, the 21st, I think.
And a half.
Or the 20th. I think they go for those few days.
Really?
Because when they go back to school in January, they go back to school on, like, a Wednesday.
That's so dumb. I hated going back to school in the middle of the week.
No, it makes total sense. Think about it. You've been out of school for 2 weeks. So you're going to have a really hard time just, like, jumping right back into a full week of school. But if you just have a few days, it makes it easier to adjust.
I think we talked about this before.
I think that it's so much better not, to just start in the middle of the week. Anyways, we're digressing. Do you have any cool holiday traditions? I'd like to know, Wargamer Sean.
Or everybody.
Or everybody, but he asked the question.
I know. But typically you ask a question to everybody. It's one of the things you used to do.
Let's just rewind.
That is a tradition on this Q&A video. You ask a question.
Okay. Atomic dog scale model freak. Doodle, that cake shop, Gilbert R, Arizona, Ice for Life, is less than a mile from where I live. I'm there. My birthday is Friday. That dog. December 9th. Sorry, the dog is like chewing up his butt. It's so gross.
Oh, I didn't tell you happy birthday.
Oh, you didn't say happy birthday. Well, happy birthday.
Yeah, happy late
happy
birthday.
Happy birthday to... Oh, we don't have the money for that.
Keep going.
Anyways, December 9th, 43 years old. 43 years young. No question. No, that's supposed to be down. No. What are you?
Okay, I'll get it back down.
No question this time. You guys rock. Take care. You have to let us know how Ice for Life was. We love Chelsea.
Yeah, she's awesome.
And follow her on Facebook and Instagram.
And in real life. We actually know her in real life.
Didn't you like tattoo her or something?
Yeah, several times.
She's got such amazing hair. Okay.
Chelsea. It's been a long time since she moved away.
Graham, thank you. Graham Collin, another cool video, guys. Congratulations on the 300 milestone, 302 as of today. And I don't know what today is.
Well, no, it's 302 still. I went up to 303 and then lost a subscriber. Then went back up to 303, lost a subscriber. I kept going back and forth from 302 to 303, but it's officially settled on 303.
Stop it. I gave him doggy tranquilizers, and he's still having a hard time, and he's wearing a cone of shame and everything. It's not a big enough cone. He keeps reaching his butt still.
Ow.
Okay. Mince/mincemeat. It's quite a bizarre thing, really. You have mince/mincemeat, which is literally minced meat. What kind of meat?
Probably whatever.
Like hamburger? Or steak? And you also have sweet mince/mincemeat, also generally just referred to as mince/mincemeat, which is mixed fruits, raisins, and such. So kind of like a fruitcake.
Ugh.
No?
That is so gross.
Sweet mince is used, obviously, in sweet dishes. And the mince pies you get at Christmas, for instance. Had to laugh at the concept of only a 5-hour drive to the coast. Only. And actually from us, it's more than 5 hours.
Yeah, because we are like further north.
We're
Texas.
Like almost to Oklahoma.
Yeah, like it takes us an hour and a half to get out of state. We can get out of state in an hour and a half
Oklahoma.
Straight up. Yeah, straight up.
Now, I think to get to the coast for us, it would be probably closer to 8.
Really? Yeah, I guess.
Because didn't it take us like 10 to get down to Galveston that one time?
It took a long time, yes.
I don't know. I think it depends on how fast you're going and traffic. Like sometimes getting out of Dallas
and
going through Houston. Those two cities are major cities. Traffic can be kind of bleh. Anyway. Either way.
Did it spill?
A little bit.
It's a lot of work. There's a lot going on in this living room right now.
Don't. Just ignore it.
I'm having a really hard time. This is why we do the videos when the children are in bed. Between the
it's
dog
not even
and
the
kids.
Children,
where did the dog go?
He went over.
What did she do? Okay. I'm so sorry. I just. If you can see what's going on, like, it just.
We have a dog knocking cups of hot cocoa off onto the floor. Luckily, they were closed, so only a little bit dripped. Anyway, 5 hours to the coast.
You could pretty much cover almost the entirety of England in that time. A pumpkin cream pie moment sounds dirty. It really does, but it sounds so delicious. I want pumpkin pie.
Speaking of pies, now this idea didn't come from her. Somebody's going to be doing a pie review thing, or if you're going to be eating pies on occasional episodes of her channel.
I can't remember who said that last week.
WG Revival. He was talking about, because we were eating the pie, he was like, he's going to make an all pie channel where he does nothing but sit and eat a pie the whole time. So she's like, I want to do that too.
I think I bought 8 already. They're mini pies. I decided I would start small and work my way up.
But she's not just going to eat the pie and just record herself eating the pies. She's going to talk about the pies and stuff. It's going to be more like a pie review channel.
But I don't know that I necessarily review pie because, like, you know, you can only review so many pies. I might, like, eat pie and talk about life and, like...
Pie, it is life.
I might, like...
Pie is life.
I might, like, smash pie in my face. Like,
well, don't give away too much of the goods. But no, like 3.14, pi is life. There you go.
There's a person.
So that's the name.
I am struggling with what to name it. And it's not going to be a separate channel. It's just going to be a playlist on my channel.
You could just like talk about
actual. Talk about pies. Anyways, I already bought the pies. I just need to. In fact, I look fabulous today. I should probably do a couple pies.
I think it should be pie is life. I think that's the perfect name for it. Because it's true. Pie is life.
Anyways. Peter Piper sells seashells. At least we didn't get the pheasant plucker tongue twisters. LOL. P. I thought for 1 minute that we were going to get the rest of the video in Morse code. Not being a video producer, I opted not to join the LOG when he started it. I did, however, float the idea of calling it Legion of the Gamged. When he was talking about setting it up. And the Willy Wonka moment, I think my chocolate would be a mix of dark milk and white chocolate, diabetic friendly and very low fat. Two things I live with are type 2 diabetes and familial high cholesterol, but not so that you would notice, and it wouldn't be too sweet, sickly, so you could happily eat lots of it. The name, how about Nom-a-Lot? I love the name. I hate white chocolate, but I love the name. I would review it for my channel.
There you go.
Sounds delicious. And I've had sugar-free chocolates before, and they're pretty good. They do have a different taste, but they're not. It's not horrible.
You know, my mom, she's diabetic too, and she'll make stuff occasionally from diabetic cookbooks and candies and stuff like that. And I know there was a couple of candies. I was like, I like these better than the original.
The Russell Stover's sugar-free chocolates are really good. But anyway. Cool. Thank you for the mincemeat and helping us digress. Mini Warzone. Question for Kristen. For me, what was the last song that you had stuck in your head, and could you sing it for us? Well, unfortunately, I can't sing songs on the channel anymore because this guy loses his videos and has to, like, fight to have them put back up. But the song that's, like, really... like, I've been listening to a lot lately is, what's the name of it? It's by the Pentatonix.
Oh.
Coldest Winter. It's only like 2 minutes long, and it's just not long enough. Like, it needs to be way longer.
It's not even a Christmas song.
It's definitely not a Christmas song, but I love it. And then, like, I guess, you know, like, just Christmas music in general has been in my head a lot. And then today at church, somebody bared their testimony about a song, about if the Savior was standing near me, and that song is like really amazing. And so that's been in my head a lot today, but again, I will not be singing any music because YouTube hates me. Like, I was worried in my video, my Snaps video, I had some Pentatonix music in it, and I was really worried that it would get kicked. But I think I don't have enough subscribers for them to care. I don't know. But he's had some music issues on this channel, so...
Yeah, that's why, if you notice, like, I've started a new... my videos have a new song on them, and I'm trying to transfer all of them over to it. And by the way, a big shout-out to the big man himself, Freakalicious at Frost and Fist, who is a musician of musicianist, who made that song for me, mm-hmm. which he is very, very cool. I thank you, sir.
Thanks for, and that's a huge help for the
thank
channel.
Thank you!
Because he was using, like, YouTube music, and it was getting, like, reported. And he's like, this is, like, music that YouTube says I can use. Why is it being reported?
I think somebody's being a jerk.
I think so. But yeah, so I would love to sing my songs for you, because we all know I have a beautiful voice.
Oh, excuse
me.
Anyway, question for Richard. If you lived in nope.
Never mind.
The dog can't be left outside alone right now because of the butt chewing.
Cancel that.
Okay, if you, honey, this is for you. If you lived in the 40K universe and had to have just one augmentation, i.e. a replacement eye, leg, arm, nose, whatever, then what would you choose and why? Probably legs. But I'm not Richard.
Well, I mean, if I was in this condition, yes. But let's say I'm in a normal condition. I would go eye, because I want to be able to see really far. Yeah, that's like an augmentation that I always thought was super cool, like a zoom or like that, or just one you can access like the internet with your eyeball. You're
ooh, like on Black Mirror.
Oh yeah, that's creepy. Yeah, but yeah.
By the way, we love that movie, that show. Thanks, UK people.
The second season wasn't as good.
Third season.
Oh, is that what we watched?
The last, third the most recent
yeah,
one.
The most recent one wasn't as good. It had good ones, but there was quite a few.
There's only like
bombers.
Three of them.
There's more than three episodes.
Each season only has like three or four.
This one had more.
No, it didn't. It didn't. It didn't. I think it was the last one that we liked on season three.
Okay.
Go ahead and look it up.
Anyway.
I'm right.
Eyeball. Eyeball.
Just like on Black Mirror, when they have like, they can like swipe left and swipe right and block people. Oh my gosh, that one was like creepy.
I'm liking you right now.
Okay, oh, and sorry if that's a spoiler for anybody who has not seen Black Mirror. She needs to go to bed. It's 8:20.
Oh yeah, it's your bedtime anyway.
Okay, there you go. Thank you for your question.
Miss out on your question.
Did she have a question?
There's a question for all the girls, but Rose will answer it for them because Rose does just as good. Too bad. Come on. Sit down and stop jumping around on the couch.
But it's late.
Honey, I'm the one that has to get up in the morning.
Okay. Chief Live Gaming. Great video, guys. Dude, we need to get a game in one of these days, Richard. That would be so sick. We could team up our Tau Seps and take on the world. Big congrats on the 300 subs, my man. For next week, if you could have two famous people as your neighbors, who would you each pick? The Obamas as one, because I love them. I don't know.
See, I read this question. That was hard for me to think. I couldn't come up with somebody that I would be like, yeah, Vin Diesel, because supposedly he's into nerdy stuff. And like, if he's legit into nerdy stuff, then yeah, Vin Diesel. He's happily married to a model.
Huh? I don't really care. He can be married all he wants. I can peek over the fence and watch him mow his yard.
He's famous. People mow his yard for him.
But then we would live in a massive house.
Anyway, and then
wait a minute, what are we talking about? The houses all around us are massive.
That's true. I don't know who the second one would be. Who'd live on the
Rock?
Side.
No. Cause he seems really humble and down to earth.
Yeah, but I don't think he's nerdy enough. You know, fine, The Rock, cause then I could work out. He could be my workout buddy.
Yeah,
I could dig that.
Well, and Vin Diesel could be your workout buddy.
True, but he's busy. We're gonna play. We're gonna roll
okay,
bikes together.
Okay, I would like The Rock and Dwayne Johnson. One on each side.
That's the same person.
I was just being silly. My back's starting to hurt. Okay.
Whoa, turn it a little bit.
Okay. So I can't think of anybody else. That's kind of a tough one because there's a lot of famous people. Robin Williams.
If he was still alive, yes.
He didn't say dead or alive.
It's kind of awkward to have a dead corpse.
And now you know that Robin Williams is, like, nerdy. Look, you look so, like, look at you. You're so slouchy. Look at that. Season 3, 6 episodes.
Told you.
Look at season 2.
No, I know season 2.
No, close down. No, don't. Would you go down to season 2? 4 episodes? And season 1?
No, season 1 had 3 episodes.
3 episodes. Okay.
I know. And they gained episodes each year.
Okay. My back's starting to hurt. We gotta get this done.
You're,
you're the one that's all slouchy. We keep this. This is a mess. We are all over the place. Frost and Fists.
Thank you, Chief.
Thanks. My man, Richard, you were treated like a normal person because you are. No different than when I hang out with my brother, Mythos. You're a man's man. We couldn't stop talking about our visit the whole way home. Thank you for being awesome hosts and being a super cool friend. Can't wait till we make our way up again. Hopefully soon. Anyways, to the questions. One, who is your favorite superhero? Spider-Man.
Exactly.
I don't have a favorite superhero.
I have two, Spider-Man and the Hulk.
So. And Ava's is her. Iron Man is Ava's favorite because he flies.
Yeah.
But then when she realized that he's really rich, that changed. But it was really cute because she was like little, like 3, 4, and like in love with Iron Man and the Hulk. Like she even has like their posters above her bed still to this day. Like it's really cute. They were her boyfriends.
Yeah.
So that's for Ava. I don't really have a favorite.
I just like Spider-Man because the agility and the acrobatics and stuff is something I always want to do. Plus, he's like an everyday man. Like, he's just, his real life is like, really? Again? And then he's like a superhero. You know, he helps so many people and everything.
He's like an uber nerd.
Yeah.
Daddy. Someone that you would totally not pay attention to in the street.
One of the themes one year was
the
Spider-Man theme.
Yeah, it was a superhero.
What was it like destroying an entire assault squad in one turn? Oh, I missed a question. LOL, I was even shocked by that one. Still hurts. I can't sit much anymore. Oh, great video, bro. Love you guys. So I skipped over his second question. It says, what would you consider as your favorite food?
Me, spaghetti. I like spaghetti.
Pizza.
Sushi.
And then hamburgers would be second. And the children are sushi and Chinese.
Yeah, there you go. And that assault squad thing, I'm still shocked. I'm sorry.
It's the game, right?
Yeah.
Like,
that just means next time we play, you're going to come at me, bro. You're going to come at me, bro.
Yeah. We love you. We love you, Freakalicious. Okay, Nerdopolis Prime. Grats on the subs, my friend. I also just subbed your missus. Thank you. Awaiting some cool fairy reviews. You know what? We did the fairy bread. I guess we need more. We need more fairiness. Fairy feet tea is really hard to review because it tastes like nothing.
It's just tea. Water.
Okay, and you can so count on me using that epic nerdo shout. Thank you, Richard. Gaming you would be such a great experience, never to be forgotten. But enough nerd fondling. Let's go for more embarrassing questions. Hope you enjoy them.
It's gonna be fun.
Mademoiselle, what was your most embarrassing public whoopsie? We'll just move on. I mean, I'll think about that. Richard, what was your most embarrassing public oopsie?
For me, I don't know. I already have issues. I go out in public, period, and I get embarrassed. I did have a wheelchair battle one time with another guy in a wheelchair. What? You remember when we went to that restaurant and we were eating? And we were like trying to back out, and we crashed into another.
And he
person.
Like didn't have legs or something, right? Like.
Yeah, I don't remember the full details. I just know it was an awkward moment and kind of embarrassing.
The wheels got like stuck together.
Kept on turning.
No,
remember when the tire fell out of the back of the car?
The tire
fell out of the back of the car at the temple.
Yeah.
And started bouncing down the street.
That was awkward. I don't know. That was embarrassing. No, that was hilarious. Okay. Here we are at this house of the Lord, you know, for our faith. And we just had this awesome spiritual moment. And I come outside. The girls get in the car. And I'm about to put the wheelchair in. So I'm reeling it to the back. And I tell my daughter to open the van door. And when she pushed the button, it's one of those electronic ones. So it goes beep. And this spare, huge, full-size spare tire falls out and starts bouncing, and I'm like in this wheelchair going no, trying to wheel the wheelchair and kick the spare tire at the same time.
I mean, it's a plus. We were extra energized. We were just sealed together for all eternity, the whole entire family. The children were allowed in the temple, and normally, you know, children aren't allowed in the temple, so it was a really epic day.
Yeah, it was crazy.
Yeah. So then he asks kids, what is the most pathetic thing your parents ever did? Sophia goes, pathetic?
What?
What?
How about embarrassing to you?
When I tried to get on the bus and I'm like, my baby!
When I was their bus, so Rose said when I was their bus driver and she tried to get on the bus and I was going, my baby! So you were like the second stop though, so there was no one on the bus to be embarrassed in front of. But I guess that's, I did do that a few times. I would embarrass her pretty good. That's what bus driver moms do, right? It's all good. It's all good. That's what moms do, right? Fia?
I'm when you spray start, you're like, come here! And you can say, come back!
Okay, so she says it's really weird when I spray the dog's butt with the itchy spray so he'd stop chewing on his butt. And I'm yelling at him and he's trying to run away. And then I would say my most embarrassing public oopsie was when I was pregnant and it was raining and I was throwing up and I peed my pants on the way to the doctor. So when I got to the doctor, I'm like, I peed.
There you go.
Well, I mean, like, it was the third baby. I don't need to explain it any further. I threw up very badly, like, 3 times a day from, like, 4 weeks all the way to delivery. Like, it was bad. I always lose weight in pregnancy. It's kind of my weight loss secret. The dog is about to throw up. Okay. He was...
Are you sure he can't go outside on his own now?
I'm serious. If he throws up right now...
That's fitting.
I mean, he is on, like, trazodone or something like that. Anyway.
It's okay for dogs to take.
Right, it is a doggy prescription. But anyway, yes. Pee my pants.
Yeah. I remember in kindergarten, I was walking. I stayed after school, I think, and I was walking out the door and I peed my pants.
She remembers peeing her pants in kindergarten. Rose.
This is all talk about our embarrassing moments now.
Hey, everybody pees, right? I'm sure we've all peed our pants at some point. Yes, when you were a little baby, you peed your pants. Now stop.
Okay, whatever.
Okay, thank you so much, Nerdopolis Prime.
Sorry for all this yawning, guys. I'm not tired. I'm just...
Ugh. You're so slouchy. Like, he's like...
It's not slouchy. This is slouchy.
I'll do this last question like this. Eating beer, 40K.
Okay, this is slouchy.
Eating beer, 40K.
This is slouchy.
Great Q&A. Reading!
Keep going.
Great Q&A. I went straight to Graham's comment to see that he would have a good answer for mincemeat, so I will leave that one to him. Congrats on the subs, mate. Well deserved. My question then, when you have to call from a coin being tossed, do you go heads or tails?
Tails.
I just go with the spur of the moment, like when I'm feeling. You gotta really feel it.
I just like tail.
I was just about to say I like heads.
I like heads.
That's not true. Anyway.
TMI alert! you gotta feel it.
You gotta feel it, head or tail.
Stop. Right now, I'm feeling none of it. No. Anyway, that's it. We're done.
Okay.
I'm just saying, eating beer, he's last, always. I think
because he's first. Usually. Yeah. So it just counts down.
You said someone just now.
Yeah, Nerdopolis Prime. He.
But it says, 5 hours. I thought it said 5 days ago.
No.
Oh.
5 hours ago. So. Interesting.
Nice.
So anyway, guys, we thank you so much again for this crazy ride.
And boy, has it been crazy. And stop it!
Some of our craziest. We better get off here before we kill the dog.
The dog! We need some Benadryl.
I thought we had some.
Well, it's anyway, sinus medicine.
We'll talk about Benadryl later. Off camera. Guys, we love you so much. We thank you. Again, leave comments down below, questions, likes, subs, whatever. If you're new to here, this is, I'm a nerd channel, but Mondays and Wednesdays, I do other stuff. So, anyway, I love you all. I thank you so, so very much. Keep rocking that nerd life, my friends.
And stay safe. I love you.
Oh, We'll see you later.